it'll just, I've timed this, so this should just go continuously. I won't touch the button, so I've got a specified amount of time I set myself. Except I didn't realize the first one's going to take so long. So basically, this is not a planned talk. Just yesterday, I thought, well, why shouldn't I do this? I do a lot of these conferences where I record, and I find that people think I'm the sound technician in the back. So they come and ask me questions like, where's the bathroom and what have you. So I thought I'd come and say, you know, I do other things too. I started with I used tech in Imperial College in the early days. For my thesis, I was actually officially the first tech user in Imperial College. I started to offer a service to publishers, and I started a typesetting business that way. About 12 years ago, I traveled to India when I heard that there was something going on in India. So very early on, before the typesetting business, I visited a few different companies, and I met this guy, Radhakrishnan, who was running a very small business. And a year later, we merged, and we became the same, basically merged into the same company. Now we're running this company in India and based almost entirely on free software. So these are some of our staff there. This is some time back. We feel more as if we're more like a family. I visit the staff. It's not as if it's not a sort of normal outsourcing business. It's our business. And I visited most of the staff at home, and I eat with them and drink with them and chat. This is where we are. We are right in the southern tip, Trivandrum, which is the southern tip of Kerala. It's one of the nicest places in India to be. The climate is tropical. It's highly educated, and you might have heard about it. Anyway, it's one of the nicest places to be in India, we feel. The beaches are, it's about half an hour drive to the beach, so that's a bit of a hassle, but it's not too bad. That's about 40 minutes from our office. What we do is we do journal typesetting. So we take the manuscript that you might submit to a technical journal, say mathematics journal, and our job is to go from that to the final copy that they print or they put out on the web. So PDF, XML, HTML, etc. It's a long process. Our workflow is going from tech to XML, back to an intermediate tech and PDF. The main thing is the XML, which is very complicated XML, including MathML, goes to PDF completely automatically. We do that with free software, and apparently no one else can do it. We're the only ones who can do it and with free software. We've generally somehow broken the rules, and we've survived. Bottom line is not the most important thing. We think that you have to trust each other more than what's written on the contract. We are honest with our staff, and we are honest with our clients. Even if we can't do anything, we're no good at something, we say it, and it's worked. Free software works for us because it's, you know, well, I'm preaching to the converted, but it's free, it's extensible because we can program it. Support is good. We just go on the web and write something and people reply. And we can plan 10, 20 years ahead knowing that no one's going to take the software away from us. Competition, we try to say this is a good way, but they want to have professional software. They pay something called 3B2, which costs more than $10,000 per computer with a dongle. Annual fees, etc. I don't know how they do it, but we couldn't do it, but that's our competition. Maybe that's why I'm always so relaxed and compared to them. We've got 140 staff. We do 15,000 pages a month, so it's grown into quite a substantial business. And we've got a scalable model, so we think we can scale even more. And we've automated everything that we can, again, almost entirely with free software, Linux, etc. The only part is graphics. There are problems. Really, it's a bit of inertia. Sometimes they say, well, do the graphics this way. Here are the Photoshop settings, or here are the distiller settings. So it's a little difficult, but we do want to go free. We want to go Inkscape. We want to go GIMP. So if you can help us with that, great. We're interested in multimedia. We want to seamlessly merge text, video, audio, etc. Smile XML extension, that's a good way to go. Again, I'm not using fully free things, but we want to go that way. Just a little plug that regarding multimedia, all of First Day's recordings are up. That's Stanny with his talk, rivervalley.tv. So they're quickly going up. And it is free to view the Flash, free player. This is a new office complex we're building. It's 4 acres of land, so quite substantial. It will be moving in there within the next few weeks, by the end of May, I think. We'll have it's quite a big land, and we'll have good conference facilities, etc. So we'd like to maybe have a LGM there one day. We'd like to invite you if you want to do a project, come over. We are very free software oriented. You can send me an email. If you want, you can come. We've got guest houses. You can stay for nothing, eat for nothing, stay as long as you like. I'll regret saying that, but I've said it now. seriously. Fine. I don't know if you've heard of this. Petr Kucha, anyone heard of this? This is basically, I have 20 slides. Each is 20 seconds, which is exactly what I did there. And it's exactly, it takes 6 minutes, 40 seconds. And so I always wanted to try it. I thought this is the best place to try it. And that's it.
So we have 3 minutes, 20 seconds for questions.
LGM 2009, or 2010, Kerala?
Yeah. Yes, no, seriously. LGM 2010, Kerala. I think we can do that. The only thing is we have one very good facility for conferences. It only takes up to 80 people in the main room. There's an overflow room for about 20 people, but with full facilities and multimedia and streaming, we'll be streaming live.
So this may be clueless, and I beg people not to kick me in the head for this, but everybody's complaining about PDFs for transferring files. And it occurs to me that one of the most reliable file formats is PostScript, because PostScript is hardwired into computers, or into printers, pardon me, and so it doesn't change a lot. And I'm wondering why people don't make more use of PostScript. You know, PostScript, you can program in PostScript. It's not difficult to use at all, and yet somehow you end up with this PDF that is difficult to use, and I'm a little baffled by that. And so I'd take the answer to that one from anybody.
Well, it won't be me, I think. I like PostScript. It's programmable. It's a programming language. We are supplying to we're a business, so they want PDF from us.
The answer would be, can you embed fonts in PostScript? Yes, okay.
I think PostScript is very well designed, but it's mainly designed as an output language. It's mainly designed as you finish editing your final product in some other format and you export it to PostScript for the final printing. But it's not a format that you can then take and then re-edit it. Usually if you look in PostScript files, each of the letters in the text are individually placed in a certain location. So it's not like you can just go in there and edit the text with something else. So it's really kind of what they call a write-only format.
Last question.
I would like to answer to that directly. Of course, the same is true for PDF. PDF was never designed to do editing later on, except for minimal stuff, and all available editors are pretty limited for PDF right now. PDF was designed as a successor of PostScript. It has some features which is not supported by PostScript. Most important, probably, transparency. And so I do like PDF. I think PDF is pretty great, and it would be even greater if it was based on XML. And I think Adobe is working on something like that, where you had this Mars project now named PDF XML, and that would make it much easier to work with PDFs.
I agree. PDF was originally electronic paper, so actually it's designed not to be edited. And the problem is if you do edit it, then things go wrong. And yes, embedded XML, that's something we're working on. We're working with Hunter Tyne of XML Tech to produce embedded XML and PDF.
Just briefly about the why not use PostScript. I think some of the issues include semantics and being able to, if you only care how the document looks, that's fine. But if you want to have semantics associated with the different things in the document, and be able to extract those, it kind of matters. And also accessibility. I don't know how accessible PostScript is, but I would guess it's not very accessible. In terms of blind users being able to kind of jump around in the document and kind of from this section to that section and things like that.
Okay, I think we have to start with the talks, but thank you very much.